Nishasenaiva Vishwas Kadarudda Bhavishyati Kirtaniyato Balyad Harennamaiva Kevalam. Gauriya Goshtipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Gopatho. We are not going to live here for long. We are not going to live here in this material world for long period. Only for 2 days we are here in this material world. So before leaving this material body, we should have a final settlement. What we need, what we don't need, there should be a final settlement of this factor. Gauriya Goshtipati, Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta, Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, we are not going to live here in this material world for a long time. Only for 2 days we are here in this material world. So before leaving this material body, we must have a final settlement of the factor that what we need and what we don't need. There should be a final settlement of this factor. Actually, point is that in Niti Shastra it is written, in Niti Shastra it is written that those who are going to get some knowledge, want to acquire some knowledge. Gyan means material gyan. And money, going to earn. Those who are ajaram arabat pragyam vidyam arthanche chintayet. Ajaram arabat, when you are going to study, get education, when you are going to earn money, then you will have to think that you are not going to die. Because if you think you are going to die, you cannot get any inspiration to earn money. Follow? So it is written in Niti Shastra that ajaram ajaravat chintayet vidyam arthan, vidya and artha, ajaram aravat pragyo, vidyam arthan cha chintayet, and grihito eva keseshu mrittuna dharmam acharet. When you are going to follow dharma, I mean Bhagavad dharma specially, then continuously you will have to think that I am going to die. Any time I can go away from this material world. Any time I can go away from this material world. Grihito eva keseshu mrittuna dharmam acharet. Then and only then you can get inspiration to follow dharma. Especially Bhagavad dharma. Otherwise you cannot get inspiration. That's why you can remember when Parikshit Maharaj sitting in front of Sukhdev Goswami, a king who has total sovereignty all over the world, is controlling, ruling. That kind of big king, Raj Chakravarti, he is going to hear Harikatha, get solution of his life from Gurudev Sukhdev Goswami Maharaj. Before starting Harikatha, Sukhdev Goswami giving warning. Hey Rajan, you must think over and again that you are going to die, you are going to die, you are going to die. Always you think that you are going to die. If that kind of fear is not there, then you cannot grow sufficient sincerity to give attention to my speech, which can change your whole life. That is the main point. That's why I am speaking. O Rajan, you think over and again that you are going to die. Tvam tu marishye Rajan iti achintayu. Tvam tu marishye iti Rajan achintayu. You go on thinking that you are going to die. But after the Harikatha is over, total Bhagavad Katha over, I already told, then Sukhdev Goswami is speaking, Rajan, never try to think, never try to think that you are going to die. Never try to think that you are going to die. Why? Because after hearing Bhagavad Katha, you can get immortality. You can get Amrita. Then you can feel from heart that you are not going to die any day, any time. Because spirit is immortal. Anyhow, you cannot destroy spirit. I can discuss gradually. So Gurudev first told that you go on thinking that you are going to die. Now after Bhagavad Katha is over, then that Sukhdev Goswami Gurudev is speaking, Tvam tu marishye Rajan iti pashubuddhi mimang jahi. Tvam tu marishye, you can die. This kind of beastly conception. It is one kind of beastly conception. You should discard, you should leave. No. You should discard this kind of conception you are going to. It is beastly conception. A beast can think that way. Tvam tu marishye Rajan, pashubuddhi mimam johi. Now why I want to give this kind of introduction before starting Gita? What is the reason behind it? Maharaj, the reason is that here Yudhishthir Maharaj, all Pancha Pandav, I mean Arjuna, everybody standing, whole troops, to fight. They are here, and the opposite party also there. They are also soldiers, all in queue. They are standing to start fight. And why Arjuna requesting Krishna to take the chariot in between the two, party? Why Arjuna requesting Krishna to take the chariot in between the two parties? What is the reason? And also, Krishna is acting as driver, coachman. He is going to follow the instruction of Arjuna. He is doing the same. He is taking the chariot in between the two parties. Why? Because Arjuna wanted to have a look. Total. Arjuna wanted to have a look. Both the parties. Especially those are Kaurava. And why I started with the sloka? Because you can remember, Duryodhana want to capture the whole, country. And though Duryodhana having full knowledge that he is not going to do any justice. Duryodhana have a good knowledge. He is totally wakivahal. He is totally aware about this thing that I am doing wrong. I am not doing any justice. And why Duryodhana want to grasp the whole property, everything, country, everything, why? That's why I started with the sloka. If you want to enjoy, if you want to have a material enjoyment, if you want to gather huge amount of property, money, everything, if you want to gather material education, in that case, 100% you are not going to remember that you are going to die anytime. If this kind of conception going to back, give a backing to you, then surely you are not going to, because you know, Maharaj, any time I can die. What use? Wasting time. So to project conception of Duryodhana and to project the conception of Arjuna, I was bound to speak this sloka. Duryodhana is not Vaishnava, you know. But Arjuna, I mean Panchapanda, they are all Vaishnava. Why they are Vaishnava? Because they have taken shelter unto the lotus feet of Krishna, Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan. That's why they are Vaishnava. And Duryodhana don't care. Who is Vaishnava? Who is Vaishnava? Who is Guru? Don't care. Who is Krishna? That's why I was bound to project two different attitude of two different person, like Duryodhana and Arjuna. So now Arjuna, feeling some sort, some kind of sensation. Arjuna feeling some sort of sensation. And you can remember one thing. You can remember one thing that when Yudhishthira Maharaj was enjoying the whole, you know, power, after Kurukshetra Yudh fighting is over, when Yudhishthira Maharaj sitting on the throne and ruling the whole world, then one thing happened. I like to speak this thing, very nice. You can remember, when Yudhishthira Maharaj already ruling the whole world by the mercy of Krishna, in that case, one day Yudhishthira Maharaj sitting and two people came in front of you to seek for justice. What's the reason? One is very poor man. He is always cultivating the land, you see. He is always cultivating the land. He is a farmer actually. Another man is a landlord. Another man is landlord. He is big, rich man. Now actually, the rich man and the landlord, both they are coming in front of Yudhishthira Maharaj to seek for justice. Why? What is the reason? Actually, Yudhishthira Maharaj wanted to know the reason for why you have come. They are speaking one by one. Landlord speaking, Maharaj, I give one big piece of land for cultivation to this poor man. He can cultivate and take whatever he like. He can give me some paddy or wheat, whatever he grow, he can give some share, that much. But I give the land to him, he can cultivate whatever responsibility there in the land. I have no responsibility, he is going to take charge of the land, he can cultivate the land and grow paddy or wheat, sabji, whatever he like. He can give me some share of that and nothing else. Now, when he is, you know, plowing the land, you know, in that case, he find a huge amount of golden coin inside the earth, there. And he come in front of me, he is coming in front of me, I mean, that Maharaj, it is your, because the land is your. So I can hand over all golden coin to you, because the land is your. And you give me this land, this much actually, you give me the land. You are giving the land to me. But the landlord speaking, no, I give responsibility of that land to you. The property discovered, all you can take away. I have no right on it. Then both of them fighting. Follow. They are coming to Yudhishthira Maharaj to seek for justice. Yudhishthira Maharaj say, okay, both of you fighting, you can do one thing. First of all, you try to find out settlement among, by you can give, keep deposit of that property with this, my treasure. I mean, I am king. Here treasure, you can keep this property. Because anyway, if you put this property here in my king's treasure, then whole country can enjoy the benefit. So both of them gone. Problem finished. But after some time, after a long period, both of them fighting and coming in front of Yudhishthira Maharaj with this issue, that Maharaj, that piece of land I give to that farmer for cultivation only. So I have my right over that property, so you give me that property. And the farmer also speaking, no Maharaj, I was cultivating that land, I found that property, I have right over that property. Yudhishthira, what happens? Long ago, they came to me with the same issue, but the reason was just opposite. But now they are fighting with each other, what's the reason? Yudhishthira took decision, oh, right, that's mean, surely Koli progressing. Yudhishthira Maharaj was sure about this factor that 100% Koli already entering, step into. Otherwise, how they are fighting? Some days ago they came with the issue, but the argument was very nice. But now they are fighting with each other, same thing. So now you see, this is the reason why I am bound to give this example, because Kali already entering. Kali going to enter. That's why already has some influence. When Krishna up to that point, when Krishna was there on this earth, still then Kali couldn't put in a big influence. But still, Kali coming. After Krishna gone, then Kali already entered. That time actually, you know, this kind of fighting took place. The landlord speaking the just opposite what he spoke before. There is a reason. Now, Yudhishthira Maharaj and everybody standing, and Arjun giving instruction to Krishna, and Sanjay going to make a relay of this fact. What? Bhajaya Sanjay Vacha Evam Mukto Rishi Kesha Guru Guda Keshena Varata Senayor Uvayar Madhya Stapa Itva Ratattamam Vishmo Drono Pramukhataha Sarveshancha Mahikshitam Uvacha Partha Pashaitam Samavitano Kuruna Iti. I already discussed this point already. Already I discussed this point. So, tatra pashyat sthitan parthaha pitrina atho pitamahana acharyano matulano bhatrino putrano poutrano sakhinstatha shashurano shruhidas chaiva senayur uvayur upi. On both the side, Arjuna watching that those acharyas, their grandfathers, their grand-grandfathers, their brothers and friends, everybody there, the maternal uncles, paternal uncles, sons and all relatives, friends, father-in-laws, everybody, they are all standing in front of us to fight with us. They say both the party ready to fight. In that case, Arjun watching with very sympathetic attitude. Arjun with very sympathetic attitude watching, and here actually Sanjay speaking, the Tano Samiksho, after watching them, Sa Kantiyaha Sarvana Bandhuna Avasthitana Kripaya Parayavishto Vishidan Idam Avabrit. After watching very carefully, who all are there to fight with us very carefully, Arjun growing some sympathy. Kripaya Parayavishto Vishidan Idam Avabrit. He become very sad. After that, actually, he started speaking in front of Krishna. Do you think it is one kind of kindness shown by Arjun? Arjun now going to show some sympathetic attitude. But this is not the time to show that kind of attitude. But anyway, Arjun want to think that way, that if I fight with them, all friends, kith and kins, all my relatives, everybody there, if I fight, surely I am going to kill them. In that case, how I can kill them? Is it possible for me to kill them? This kind of erroneous activity is not possible for me to show. My heart is not so strong. I have some sympathy. Arjuna want to show that kind of attitude. So here Arjuna vacha, drishte mam sajjanam Krishna Jujusvam samapasthitam Siddhanti mama gatrani mukhancho parishishyati. Arjuna now speaking in front of Krishna, O Krishna, drishtemam sajjanam. I am watching, they are all my friends, you know, relatives. And after watching them, body totally drying. You know, Siddhanti mama gatrani mukhancha parishishati. You know, avashanna, I am feeling some sort of, as if I am losing my activities. Avasanna, infatuation. Avasanna. So actually, you see, I am going to lose my power, all my limbs and my activities. I cannot show my activities. I am going to, lose all my spirit and my face and tongue drying off. What to do? I don't understand what to do. After that, actually, Arjuna speaking, Bepathuscha sarire me romo harsasya jayate gandivam sangsrati hastyattaka chaiva paridajyate. Bepathuscha mane trembling, shaking, you know. All my body is shaking actually. Bepathuscha sarire me romo harsasya jayate, my hair standing on the tips. All my hair standing. And from my hand, Gandiva going, I am going to lose Gandhi from my hands automatically. And my skin, you know, it just I am feeling some burning. I am feeling some burning said. All my skin burning as if what to do, I don't know. Why? Because Arjuna growing some sympathy, that's why growing some, you know, this kind of, you know, unusual thing. Actually, before fighting, Arjuna expressing this kind of attitude, which is just, which is not, you know, likely, which is not proper. Nacha saknomi avasthatum brahmativa chome manaha, my mind rotating, my mind, you know, I cannot fix up my mind. Brahmati, my mind, you know, moving around. Nacha saknomi avasthatum, I cannot stand just in front of them. Nimittani cha pasyami viparitani kesava durlaksham omens. Omens of, you know, very bad thing. Omens mean signal. Omens mean signal. A very bad thing. Unauspicious. It is not auspicious. I am feeling some omens of inauspicious, you know, things. I don't know what to do. Nimittani chapa swami viparitani keshava. I am feeling just opposite. What to do? Now, after that, Arjuna can don't like to fight this way. Arjuna growing this kind of feeling. Not or now Arjuna going to give argument. Follow. Now Arjuna going to give argument one by one. Na cha shreyo anupaswami hatva sajjana mahave na kankhe vijayam krishna na cha rajyan sukhani cha. Na cha shreyo anupaswami, I am not going to see any good. Shreyo. Nacha Sreya Anupaswami Hatva Sajjanam Ahave. Ahave means in this fighting, if I am going to kill them all standing in front of me, they are all my friends and relatives, I think I cannot get any good. Nacha Sreya Anupaswami Hatva Sajjanam Ahave. Mahave means in this fighting, big fighting, I am not going to look any good. Na kankhe vijayam krishna na cha rajyan sukhani cha. Hey Krishna, I don't want to come out successful in this fighting. I don't want victory. I don't want to enjoy the kingship. Na kankhe vijayam krishna na cha rajyan sukhani cha. I don't want, I like to leave everything. Now Arjuna want to prove that he is very dharmic. Dharmic means he is in favor of dharma. So he is giving one by one argument. King no Rajena Govinda King Bhogoid Jivitenova Jesham Arthe Kankitam no Rajam Bhogaha Sukhanicha. The reason for why we are going to get victory? Because after we come out successful, we want to enjoy. I mean the kingship and whole property and for them, for whom all we are doing. If they are going to die, then what use? If they are going to die, then what use? What use? We are going to get this victory, enjoy this kingship. King no Rajyena Govinda, what we can do? Useless for us. King no Rajyena Govinda, King Bhogair Jivitenova. Jesham arthe kankitam no rajyan bhogaha sukhanicha. You can remember, I already told one, you know, very nice story. Napoleon Bonaparte was sent to a very, very lonely place, Aslan, exile. Last time, he was caught and sent there, on Tarif. I already told, one incident, that we are going to get property for why? If I give you huge amount of property, if I want to banish you, send you to a lonely island, you like to stay there with huge amount of property? If there is no relative, no friends, nothing, nobody there, I can give you huge amount of property, be sure. But I can send you, I like to send you to a very lonely place. You like to go? No. Actually, point is that Atma va ared ashtabhyo satabhyo nididhyasitabhyo. If there is no Atma, if there is no human being, especially if there is no relative and friends there, what I can do with my property? What is the utility of that property? That is the reason. We want to enjoy property and everything in respect of my surrounding situation. If the surrounding situation is positive, then we like to enjoy. If there is huge amount of property, if you send me to a lonely place, solitary place, what use? You can remember, I was discussing the glories of Bhagavatam. When Parikshit Maharaj was given the control over the kingship there in Delhi, Hastinapur, in the Prastha, after Krishna gone, Panchapandav gone, because Panchapandav, when Panchapandav going, Yudhishthira Maharaj giving this power, Abhishek, and after that they gone. But here, Krishna's grandson, Prapautro, Bajranabo was given control over this Mathura zone. But Bajranabo crying, what I can do? There is nobody there in this forest. What use? You make me king here? Only monkeys are there. What I can do? Nobody is there. I don't like to stay here. Then actually, from there actually, Janmejaya was given control ultimately. And here, actually Krishna Prapautra, grandson, here Bajranabha. From there, Janmejaya sent huge amount of Brahmins and everybody. From there, they can't give special facility. King promised them, I am going to give you special facility for you all. Huge amount of land we can give, special offer on behalf of kings. You can enjoy everything. Why not you go to Mathura? It is the land of Krishna. They all become ready. On what ground? That king can give a special honor, special facility. Then those Brahmins and some other caste also, they are coming here. to become an inhabitant of Mathura. They are called Haivasi, not Brajavasi. Yes, you don't know. Brajavasi is their originally, their parampara, their relative after relative, they are, you know, taking birth, they are actually Brajavasi. Originally, they are coming from Brajabhumi. But those who are Haivasi, actually originally, they were sent by Janmajaya here to enrich the, you know, field. Because nobody there. Thousands or lakhs of people sent there with some special facility. Then actually Vajranabhu was satisfied. Before that, Vajranabhu was crying, with whom? You make me king here? Oh, nobody here. That is the reason. Follow. So, something here, Arjuna speaking. We have some relation with them in this big fighting. Automatically, if they are going to die, then what's the reason? For what sake? We are going to enjoy. If we have no relationship with them, they are going to die. What use? King no Rajeno Govindo King Bhogoi Rijibitenova Yesham Arthe Kankitam no Rajam Bhogaha Sukhanicha. So this is the argument given by Arjuna. Arjuna also speaking, to ime avasthita yudhye pranam styakta dhananicha. They are going to leave their body and properties, everything. To ime avasthita yudhe pranang stekta dhananicha acharyaha pitaraho putrang sathaiva cha pitamaha matulaha sasuraha pautraha shalaha sammandinastatha etana na hantum ichhami ghnato opi madhusudana. Follow what I say, eh? They are all standing in front of Adiyalal, acharyas, you know, fathers, sons, grandsons, grandsons, pita maha, grandfathers, maternal, you know, uncle, in-laws, father-in-laws, all there, pautraha, you know, grandsons. Brother-in-law, salaha, sambandhinos, kith and kins, all my friends and relatives. Etano, I don't like to kill them. Etano na hantum ichhami. Etano na hantum ichhami ghnato opi madhusudana. If at all I am going to be killed by them, your attention please. If at all I am going to be killed by them, still I don't like to kill them. If at all in this fighting I am going to be killed by them, but still I am not going to kill them anyway. What to speak about the sovereignty over this world? Kingship over this world, what? If you give me three words, Sharga, Matta and Patal. Three words, still I am not ready. Opi Trailokko Rajasso Heto Kingnu Mahikrite. What about this sovereignty over this whole world? Even if you give me, you know, facility to get control over Sarga, Matta and Patal. Matta means this material world, heaven and Patal. Below, still, opi trailokko rajasya hetah kingnu mahi krite. What about the sovereignty of this material world? No, I don't like to kill them. Why? Bhaja nihatto dhato rashtano na ka priti pritihi swat janardhanaha. Hey Janardana, hey Krishna, what benefit we can get? Nihatta, Nihatta means Tva, Pat. Is Nihatva. After killing them, Dhatarashtrano, those who are in the group of Dhritarashtra, if I kill them, what benefit I am going to get? This kind of one by one argument represented by Arjuna. You can think Arjuna is a very great, you know, Dharmabit. Nihatto Dhatarashtrano, no, ka priti sat janardana, what benefit we can get? Hey Janardana, hey Krishna, after killing them, what benefit we are going to get? This kind of weakness coming one by one inside the heart of Arjuna. Arjuna also giving argument that if you want to speak me, that you should fight because it is your duty. But remember, Dharma Shastra is more than, you know, Niti Shastra. As per Niti, you are Kshatriya. It is rules. You will have to fight. But a feeling of Dharma going to grasp my heart. I am going to feel this way. What to do? I don't know. Because Arjuna speaking, Papa Meva Srayed Asman. Asman, we all can incur pap. Sinful activity is going to grab us because we can kill them. Papo meva srayed asman hattai tvana atatainaha. Arjuna speaking, they are atatai. Atatai means those who are going to give fire to your house, those who are going to give poison to you, those who are going to abduct your wife, those who are going to take away all your property, those who are going to kill you, different ways, these are called atotai. You know, atotai there. Papa meva srayed asmano hattai tano atotai naha tasmat narha vayam hantum dhaturastana sabandavano. Sajjanam hi katham hatyas sukhino sam madhavaha. Hey Madhava, after killing those kith and kins, friends and relatives, how we can get, you know, how we can get benefit, how we can become happy? Because only it is one kind of sinful activities. It is one kind of sinful activities if we kill. Papa meva srayad, meva mane definitely. It is a sinful activities and sin going to grasp us. Papa meva srayad asmano hatvai tvana etana atatainaha tasmat narha. We should not kill them. Tasmat narha vayam hantum dhatarastano savandavano. And after the speaking, Sajjanam hi katham hatya sukhino swam madhava. After killing those friends and relatives, how we can become happy? Never. Arjuna giving this kind of argument, I already told, those who are going to give those who are going to fire to your house, poison, with going to stab you, secretly stab you from backside, going to snatch all your property illegally, all your property, dhannasak, going to destroy all your property, take away your lands, going to abduct your wife. This was six kind of, you know, people are called atatai. In Shastra it is written, if you kill them, in Shastra it is written, if you kill them, there is no problem. In Shastra, it is written, if you are going to kill them, there is no problem. There is no problem, actually. So, actually, this is injustice. Arjuna giving argument this way. After that, Arjuna speaking also, yadapi ete na paswanti lobo aparhito chetasaha kulokhayakritam dosham mitro drohe cha patakam. Though we know, actually, Duryodhan is, his heart is full, he is greedy. He cannot take decision because he is always overpowered by greed. He can do any kind of injustice. It is likely for him. Because they are blind actually. Duryodhan, their party actually, they are blind. They cannot take decision. For that, why we are going to step into that kind of, activities, to kill them. Maybe they cannot take decision, they are blind, they are overpowered by Kali, they are overpowered by Maya, they are overpowered by greed. So they can come to fight, but we know, we are wise, we have our, what is good, what is bad, that kind of judgment we have with us. So, yadapi ete na pasvanti lobo aparito chetasaha. Kulakhayam kritam dosham, cool, whole race, total race, Pandava and Kaurav, they are going to be destroyed. So, they are not going to watch. They cannot see properly because they are blind. They cannot take decision properly. They cannot feel that what will happen in future. If this fighting going on, both the side, almost whole race, our successive, dynasty, they are going to die. In that case, what will happen? If our total race is destroyed, then big problem can be there. What problem? Yadapi etena paswanti lobo aparito chetasaha kulakhayakritam dosham mitto drohe chapatakam. They are not going to think about what will happen if we fight with friends and relatives, and they cannot take any decision because they are actually, they cannot play their head. They are blind actually now. But still, we will have to think. We are not blind actually, they are blind. We are not blind. So, katham na geyo asmabhi papat asmad nivartatyum kulakhya kritam dosham prapashad vir janardana katham na geyo asmabhi papat asmad nivartatyum. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Duryodhan and their party, they are blind, they cannot take decision, they are not going to look the future, what will happen after this fighting. But we are not blind, we can take decision, we are not. So we can at least arrange so that the fighting at all cannot take place. You see the situation of Arjuna. Even Arjuna giving argument, if I am killed by them at all, if they are going to kill me, still I don't like to kill them. After that, Arjuna going to give argument, I think it is good that if I become a beggar, I like to beg. but still I don't like to fight. Begging is more, far better. Begging is far better than fighting, because, oh, I am going to kill all my friends, relatives, all elderly personalities, like my acharyas, grandfathers, fathers, father-in-laws. Oh, I cannot. So why we are not going to stop? So why we cannot stop fighting? They cannot stop, but we have a right to stop. This way, this kind of argument, given by whom? Given by whom? Arjuna. Now Arjuna giving argument one by one, that here is very important. Even Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad, Baladev Vidya Abhaswan, Siddha Swami Pad, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, all big acharyas going to Ramanuja Acharya, Madhvacharya, they are all, you will have to follow this point. Otherwise you can misunderstand me, because I was giving so many arguments about Varnasam Dharma. Here I can give some evidence. Also after, sometime I can give. Arjuna going to give this kind of argument, Kulok khaye pranaswanti kulo dharmaha sanatanaha dharme naste kulam krishnam adharmo abhivavati iti uto. If the whole race is going to be destroyed, then on hereditarily they have some special ritualistic activities. Usually in all race, they have some speciality they are going to follow, parampara. Some ritualistic activities they are following, always. And if the whole, you know, destiny going to be destroyed, race, how? They cannot follow. Because if parampara, after one by one, they are going to follow. From grandfather I learned, father my father, from father I learned how to lead life, how to follow some ritualistic activities, specially there in my destiny. But all they are going to lose. Because who is going to guide? Who is going to guide if they all going to die, nobody there to guide them properly. Kulokhaye pranasanti kulo dharmaha sanatanaha. Sanatana dharma, Bhagavad dharma, and all ritualistic activities related to Sanatana dharma, Bhagavad dharma, all going to lose, going to get lost. Dharme naste kulam krishnam adharmam abhivavati uto iti uto. If dharma is destroyed, then whole parampara, I mean my destiny, they mean race, all they can lose their position. They can be misled, and from there, because they cannot get proper instruction, then from there, adharma. Then dharma, then nobody can guide what is dharma. Then adharma can get some place there. Automatically adharma can get place in place of dharma. Because who is going to guide? If everybody dies, nobody there. So sometime you can remember, sometime we are going to ask our senior devotees or father, forefather, what to, in this situation, what to do? They are guiding us. This way we'll have to do. And who can get wise if nobody is there? Here one thing is very important. Adharma abhibhavat, if there is adharma, if nobody going to follow dharma, namely adharma, going to grasp the whole society. In that case, Krishna pradushanti kulastriyaha. In our race, those who are very beautiful women, very nice, they have their character very nice, they can also lose their standpoints. Follow? They can become contaminated because nobody there. So, adharma abhibhavat Krishna pradushanti kulostriyaha. All our, you know, women in our race, they have some prestige, they have some quality. But who can guide them? Automatically there is a mismanagement. Dharma is not there, adharma can take place, and then they are bound to go here and there. They can get association of different caste, then some mixing of caste, ultimately going to make a big mismanagement in this society. What is the situation at present? Strishu dushtasu varseyo jayate varna sankaraha. Admixture and a mixing of caste is called varna sankar. Those who are actually, those women, they lose character, they can get scope. Especially, those who are good women, they like to save themselves. But still they cannot save because nobody to protect them. And what to speak about those who are actually loose character, they can have their scope. They can go here and there, mix, and as a result, they can give birth to, you know, mixed cart. I mean, caste. Mixing of caste. It's very bad. Strishu, dushtasu, those who are wicked women, he varsiyo, from them, automatically mixing of caste. Then automatically, there is all contamination can take place, and from there, from them, gradually, if one flow of caste flowing, then they, in that caste, flow of caste, we cannot get any purity. Follow, you see? What is? Automatically? Bhaktivinoda Thakur also giving nice argument. Very nice argument about this. 40. I am going to discuss this point. Kulo khaye pranasanti kulo dharmaha sanatanaha dharme naste kulam krishnam adharma abhibhavati uto. Possibility, every possibility is there. There can be contamination in our race. Adharma abhibhavat krishna pradushanti kulo striyaha strishu dushtasu varseyo jayate varna sankaraha. And sankaro narakayaiva kulagnanam kulasacha patanti pitaro hi esham lupto pindo dakokriya. Try to follow, read very nicely, pronunciation, follow. And if there is, you know, mixing of caste, then the total system can break down. Then all our forefathers, Who is going to give, offer their funeral cakes and water yearly? Shraddha? Yearly shraddha, you know? All these things. Who is going to? Because nobody there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving nice argument. I can read in front of you. Follow. Sankaro narakayaivo. Arjun speaking. If there is this kind of situation, then all, they can go to hell. Because nobody there, all our forefathers, they cannot get water and funeral cakes. Automatically, who is going to give them water? Nobody there. They are going to go down in hell. Sankaro narakayaivo kulognanam kulasacha. The whole race going to hell. There is no system now. All breakdown, and patanti pitorohi esham. In that, you know, race, if they, your father, forefather, forefather, they are not going to get any water and funeral cakes. Who can offer them? Patanti pitorohi esham lupto pindo dokokke. Pinde pindo min funeral cakes and water. Nobody going to do. Then all system can break down. All your forefather, all the whole race going to stay in hell forever. Now what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking? I am reading Sanskrit. Huh? He Krishna, adharma abhibhavat, adharma abhibhavat, kula striyaha pradu shanti, strisu dushtasu varna sankaraha yayate, sankaro kulagnanam kulasacha narakayo eva, esham luptapindo daka kriyaha, pitaraha patantihi, nishchitameva. Definitely they are going to hell. Because nobody going to save them. Putro, putro, this Sanskrit word. In Bengali also putro. In Chaitanya Chodi you can find putro, this word is from Pung Namak Narok, from hell, named Pung. Going to save father is called putro. Why putro, this word, this putro, this word, where from coming? This word coming because putro going to save father from falling down into Pung Namak hell. Because he is going to follow all ritualistic activities what is there in Sanatana Dharma and not going to break. In that case, father can enjoy in heavenly planet. Big problem otherwise. So actually, Baladev Vidyabhushan also speaking. Baladev Vidyabhushan also speaking here very nicely. Very nicely, same thing actually speaking. Baladev, no nu ahuto no nivart. Oh, it is separate actually here. Kulokhai. Here Baladev speaking, dosa meva prapanchayati kulokhai iti. Dosa meva, there can be fault, big fault. There adharma can take place in this race. Kulo dharma, kulo chita, agni hotra, hotra dayo dharmaha, sanatanaha, kulo parampara praptaha, pranashanti kartum. Kortur vinashvat. This way, dharme naste sati avasistam baladi krishnam upi kulo kulam adharmo obhibhavati grasati iti artha. Grabs. Then gradually, the darkness adharma can grasp the whole society. There you can find no way. No, so now I want to give some argument. You can remember why I told that Varnasam Dharma is not bad thing. Varnasam Dharma is not bad thing. It is most scientific procedure. It is most scientific procedure shown by Krishna. Krishna already told. Chaturvarna maya system gunakarma vivaga saha tasya kartaram upi vidhimam akartaram akartaram abhyayam. I am out of this, but still I was bound to create the segregation according to their activities. Chaturvarna maya system gunakarma vivaga into qualities. Gun among karma, according to gun qualities and karma, what they are bound to do. According to that, I was bound to make a nice segregation so that the system can be very scientific. But people saying, those are political leaders, no, there should not be any kind of, you know, no, Mara, it is not any kind of apartheid attitude which was effective in Africa. In Africa, there was an apartheid system. Those who are black people, All the time white people going to, you know, put some pressure on them. But it is not like that. Krishna speaking is most scientific. If you follow this scientific procedure, then the whole system of the society can flow like Ganga. Like Ganga is always pure. So there cannot be any contamination. Try to understand. Don't become angry with me. What Krishna wants is so... Yes, many people become angry with me if I speak this way. Those political leaders, they want to abolish this system. No. They are foolish number one, idiot. Varnasam Sarma should be there. But undue advantage of misuse is very bad. Varnasam Dharma is not bad. If you are going to misuse, then it is bad. If you are not going to apply properly, going to get some undue advantage, then it is problem. Otherwise, Varnasam Dharma is not problem. It is very good. And actually, if you follow Varnasam Dharma, then all sannyasi, they can follow their own duty. They cannot lead their life like grihastha people at present they are leading. They have the specific criteria they will have to follow. Why they are leading life like grihastha people? There are some system and rules and regulation. So sannyasis, they should follow their system. Those who are brahmachari, they can follow their systems. Grihastha, they can follow their system. And Banaprastha, they can also follow their system. There is no disturbance. You are making disturbance and you are putting some allegation against Krishna. If you scientific procedure, if you follow this scientific procedure, then there is no problem. Because whole India, from long time, from Rishi Muni period, they are following this system. That is called Varnasam Dharma. Follow. It's said by Krishna and Rishi Muni, they are used to follow this system. I am not going to say that you cannot do bhakti, you can go back to your country. Not that. Hari bhakti, Prabhupada speaking, bhakti is a natural function of your soul. Irrespective of caste and creeds, everybody can start Hari Bhajan. Not that you cannot start Hari Bhajan. I am saying in India I can do Hari Bhajan. No! Not that. You can do Hari Bhajan as well. Maybe you can come out successful. Maybe you are coming from Africa. Maybe you are coming from Australia. Who can say? I am not speaking about thing. Hari Bhajan is a natural function of soul. I already told, even one elephant was giving Harinam by Rasikananda Prabhu. And he was doing Seva whole life, rest of his life. So not that you cannot come out successful, I am not speaking. Only I want to say, under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, all my Guru Varga, that you have no right to contaminate the whole system. Follow. Only it is my request. That's why I told, you have taken skirt thread, you have taken Brahman initiation from your Gurudev. Well, you can do it. You are going to enjoy Paramarthik Brahmanatta, but you have no right to go outside to break the total system of the society. Is very injustice. Follow. To snatch the duties of Brahman is offensive. To snatch the duty of Kshatriya is offensive. But there is some criteria. There is some advice in Shastra. Suppose Brahman, they are now in big problem. Some sensitive situation now prevailing in society. What to do? They cannot maintain their life that way. In that case, it is advised Manu Maharaj, in Manu Sangita speaking, at all if there is any dangerous situation, like where? All country, where? World where? Eh? Like world where? Big problem, nobody can follow system. In that case, Manu Maharaj speaking, Brahman can at least come down to second level. Second level. Like you know, Dronacharya was bound to follow this system. Kshatriya. Actually, Dronacharya is not Kshatriya. Dronacharya is actually Brahman. But he was following the duties of Kshatriya because situation demanding. And those who are Kshatriya, in this kind of sensitive situation, if they cannot maintain their life according to instruction of the Shastra, at least they can come down to the second level. I mean, they are Kshatriya, they can follow the system of Vaishya. Follow what I say. This way, there is some tolerance, the tolerance there. No problem, then you are not going to lose your position. Follow. That's why, if we go on reading Gita scientifically, after that we can find that there Krishna going to give advice, who is Kshatriya, who is Brahman, who is Vaishya, who is Shudra, all different criteria Krishna going to set up. This, they can be called Brahman, they can be called Kshatriya. But what I mean to say, don't misunderstand me. So mixing of caste is not at all allowed. Mixing of caste is not at all allowed. If at all somehow done, in that case in Bhagavatam we see there, Śrīta Gosvāmī speaking, Bayam, we are actually what? Actually, Śrīta. Śrīta Dev Gosvāmī speaking, because maybe his father was Brahman, mother was Kshatriya, or just opposite, Anulom Bilom. Bilom means mother Brahman, father Kshatriya. Even that is also not appreciable. Follow? Even this is also not appreciable. In newspaper, if you want to read, if you can read Bengali, if you go to Bengali newspaper, you can see regarding marriage arrangement, there are news coming, appear. We like to give our daughter away in marriage. We want to get one suitable, you know, candidate. Savarna, asavarna. Brahman want to find Brahman. But at present, this situation totally break down. But still, this kind of admixture is not allowed. If somebody want to go outside and marry foreign lady, actually, in Gita, actually, this kind of system is not allowed. You can marry, it is your own duty, if you can do. But actually, Sankaro Narakayaivo, it can take you into hell. Daiva Varna Sam, if you read and try to apply very scientifically, then you can see it is a very nice system. But we want to take undue advantage of this system. Follow? That is the main problem. Always we want to take undue advantage of this Daiva Varnasam. That is the whole, that is why whole, you know, social system breaking down. At present situation is that you cannot go and find that a Brahmin family is just pure. Some sort of contamination going there. At least 500 years back, 1000 years back, 2000 years back, there was some system. They used to follow that time. Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, Nimbaja, that time, previous, they used to follow. And they, if any Brahman, in any Brahman family, if they detect one son in a family, he is just showing Kshatriya attitude. then used to give them Khatriya. Yes, that is the scientific system, that is called Daiva Varnasam. That is called actually Daiva Varnasam. Follow. Suppose in one Brahmin family, one boy took birth. Now gradually he is showing the attitude of Khatriya. Then the Rishi, they are making system, you can be treated as a Khatriya. Even in Khatriya, you know, family, if one Sean Carving is just exhibiting Brahmin quality, Daiva Varnasama. But at present, Daiva Varnasama is not there, and what to speak about Varnasama? Daiva Varnasama is not scientifically applicable. Who is going to judge? Who is going to judge? Everybody is speaking, I am Brahman, my son is Brahman. At present, they are demanding, they are fighting with each other. Not only that, they are speaking, we are coming in the race of Nityananda. What foolish idiot. Nityananda is not a man of flesh and blood so that you can draw a conclusion like this. Hereditary factor you can draw? Nityananda is a man of, you know, blood and flesh. They are speaking, Jat Gosai. Oh, you are coming from Nityananda. Nityananda Bhangshadbhu, foolish number one. It's not possible. So, be careful, it is written, even hybrid, sabji, flower hybrid, all prohibited. Even I don't like. I give instruction to my, you know, those devotees saying, if you go to market to buy sabji, don't try to get hybrid. Hybrid is this much. Big. No, don't get. Chemical and hybrid admixture, that's not good. Maybe some clue they got from foreign country, they are coming and making this. Mixing. So, Sankaro Naraka Yoyiva Kulognanam Kulasacha Patanti Pitorohi Esham Lupto Pindo Dokokriyaha. You can follow your, you know, because you are giving Brahman, you are now, you have taken Skartharsibai, but you are going to follow your system. It is called actually, what I say? Paramarthik Brahmanatva. Not that you can go and snatch the duty of Brahman, you can start doing worship, this, that, outside and earn money. No, you are not allowed. Bhaktivinoda says, no, it is not system. That is why I told the Haridas Thakur enjoying the full honor. Haridas Thakur going to enjoy the topmost honor in whole Vaishnava society. Even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving you topmost honor. But still, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu not going to break the rules and regulations. That's why when Mahaprabhu calling, where is Haridas? Call him here. Gambira, please call him. Prabhu calling you inside, Gambira. Haridas crying, I have no power to go inside. There is all pure Vaishnavas there. Yes, I have no power. Because I have come in low family, in Javan family. When Mahaprabhu heard it, Mahaprabhu never put pressure on Haridas. You must come. Because Mahaprabhu wanted to keep balance. Mahaprabhu going to give full kippah to Haridas Thakur? What it concern to me if you are not going to give full honor to Haridas Thakur? Mahaprabhu already giving full honor. Haridas Thakur less interested to get your honor. Haridas Thakur never wanted to prove that I am more than Brahman. Haridas Thakur never wanted to prove more than Brahman. But that was proved by Advaita Gosai. As a Shraddha of his father, Kuber. Shraddha ceremony, at the Shraddha ceremony of his father, Kuber. I already told, you can remember. Advaita Acharya, bring this Haridas Thakur and keep the plate of Sraddha to him. All Brahman society going against, you are doing all wrong. Why you are doing this way? You are insulting us. We cannot take prasadam here. We can go away. They become very angry, gone. But still, Advaita Gosai giving the plate, Sraddha plate, to Haridas Thakur, because Haridas Thakur is the fittest person. And Advaita Gosai was bound to give this argument. When Haridas Thakur crying and giving this, why you are doing this way? Actually, everybody like to insult you. I'm actually from Javan family. I have no power to take the Sraddha plate. Advaita Gosai, no! I'm not going to break rules and regulations in this version of society. In this, you know, Bhagavad Dharma. No, I'm not going to mess. Advaita Gosai speaking there. Sei acharibo jei shastomoto koi. Advaita Gosai speaking, I am going to follow strict rules and regulations what is there laid down in scriptures. I am not going to make, I am not going to break the system. Tumi khaile koti brahman bhajan hoy. Crores of brahman, if I arrange prasadam for them and if I give prasadam to you, it is not just equal to that. You alone, I am going to give this plate to you alone. It is not just equal to if I am going to give prasadam to crores of Brahman. Tumi khaile koti Brahman bhojan hoy. So what about Brahman? What about Vaishnav? Vaishnav is more and more than Brahman. Vaishnav is more and more than Brahman. But Vaishnav never tried to break the total system. Because otherwise people, they are ignorant. They cannot follow. Follow what I say. That's why Haridas Thakur coming in a Javan family, still enjoying Sraddha Patra, Haridas Thakur, I am right. Then after that Brahman all came, Advaita give honor to them and arrange prasadam. Follow what I say. So whole system should be there. We cannot break the system. You can remember the case, another case I can speak. Don't try to misunderstand those who are going to hear this Harikatha. They can misunderstand me. If they cannot follow properly. You can remember one instance, Jharu Thakur. You heard the name of Jharu Thakur? He is from a very low caste. Jharu Thakur is the Parshad of Harida, Parshad of Mahaprabhu, Jharu Thakur. But from very low caste, very low family. One day, the uncle of Raghunath Das Goswai, going there with all mangoes, a box of mangoes, and offering and paying dandavat to lotus feet, glorifying. After that, giving this mango fruits to him, please offer to Krishna and try to take this prasadam. I bring this, you know, for you. Okay. They all sit and having some nice istakasti. Hello? He is sitting and having some ishtagasti, very nice ishtagasti. After that, Jharu Thakur crying. Actually, I am unlucky. You are coming in my house, I cannot arrange rice, a prasadam for you because I am from low caste, how I can arrange? But if you permit me that I can take all rice and you know, sabji, everything to that Brahmin house, they are also very pure. I know them. If you agree, I can give all, you know, raw materials. I mean, rice, dal, sabji, everything there, they can cook If you take prasadam here, don't be busy. I have taken prasadam already. I am coming to you just to take darshan of your lotus feet, to get kripa. Don't speak that way. That's it. You wanted to get the uchista of Jaru Thakur, but Jaru Thakur not going to give because I am from low family. How I can give? In that case, he was playing a trick. He is going in a bush, to hide himself. Then Jaru Thakur giving order to wife, go and offer this mango to Krishna, because the Vaishnava giving. Then after that, offering to Krishna and started enjoying the prasadam. After that, the skin and the, the seed was thrown in a box, dustbin box. Then that man, the uncle, coming and taking this, skin and this, seed and licking and enjoying, shedding tears. Today I am lucky, I am getting the prasadam of Vaishnava. Always try to remember that the food remains of Vaishnavas, water wash of the lotus feet of Vaishnavas, and the dust particle from the lotus feet of Vaishnavas, three great medicine to give bumper success in my life if I am going to trust 100%. So the dust particle from the lotus feet of Vaishnavas, food remains of Vaishnavas, and the water wash. Tin sadhaner bol, bhakta bhukta shesh, bhakta pada jal, bhakta pada renew, it is three. Very, very powerful medicine in your life. You can prove. You should have 100% believe in it. Follow what I say. That is the reason that the uncle of Raghunath Das Goswami given a topmost chance, rare chance, to take the water wash of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Nobody, even birds and, beasts, they cannot even take one drop of water from the water wash of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Every day Mahaprabhu washing leg from the pot, garu, in Sanskrit or Bengali you said garu. From pot, Govinda giving water and Mahaprabhu wash, then enter temple. But nobody is going to take, because Mahaprabhu is very strict. But that day, he is going to take three times. One time taking, another time taking, another time taking. Mahaprabhu, no more. Okay. That I allow. Why? Because you have 100% belief in the Uchishta of Vaishnava. So you buy me. You are successful to buy me. No more. Three times I allow, because I know your heart. You see how successful the uncle of Raghunath Das Goswami. This way you see the mood of Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu never wanted to break the total system of the society. At the same time, Mahaprabhu going to give full honor to them. I already told, when Mahaprabhu reached there in Varanasi, Chandrasekhar Acharya Bhavan staying and taking prasadam, they are in the house of Tapan Mishra. Why? Because Mahaprabhu never wanted to break the system. Because ignorant people, Mahaprabhu can take easily. Mahaprabhu can take easily. In Jagannath, we know Jagannath can take prasadam from anybody at the time of Rath Yatra. If he is from low caste, even he is going to burn dead body, dome, charal, still he is going to take bath and going to give coconut and everything to Jagannath. Jagannath, you know, that was a special offer of Jagannath. Now I am in Rath, chariot. Now my kippah is open to all. My kippah is always open to all. But this time, what seva you have no right to do. Now I am in on chariot. Now everybody allowed to serve me anywhere, whatever they, whatever you like, you can offer to me. No restriction. Now you know, Jagannath originally came in the form of Nilmadhav. So Nilmadhav, you the origin of Nilmadhav, you know, and how Nilmadhav took seva from Vishvavasu. You know the system. So Jagannath is all powerful. Jagannath can take from anybody, but still Ramanujacharya, Madhvacharya, all Nimbarkacharya, all our Vaishnava society, they never wanted to disturb the social system. At the same, they are ready to give full honor to Guru Vaishnava. That's why when Rai Ramananda Sangha took place, then Jai Krishna Tattvavetta Sai Guru Hoy. Who is Guru? Maharaj, Guru should be Brahman. No! Anybody can act as Guru if he is Krishna Tattvavid. Mahaprabhu, it is the approval of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Jai Krishna Tattvavetta Sai Guru Hoy. Not that you are Brahman, you can act as Guru. Ah, well, it is written in Veda. Varnanam Brahmano Guru. Okay. If at all you are Brahman. If you are not Brahman, only if you are skirted, who can say that you are Brahman? Brahman means at least 12 qualities should be there with you. Shamo, Damo, Saucho, Sarartha, Arjabo, Shaddhaya, you should be there. But note what to speak about 12 qualities? Nothing there. He is drinking wine, taking beef. How I can say you are Brahman? I am Brahman, you see Chatterjee. You are Chatterjee Chakravarti? You are Misra? No! You are not Brahman. That is called Daiva Varna Sampalo. He is not at a Brahman. He is a fallen soul. But if one man from very low caste doing Krishna Bhajan, then he is more than a Brahman. More than a Brahman, because it is written in Shastra. It is written in Shastra. That sun god is powerful, fire is powerful, Brahman is powerful. Don't try to fight with them. But still, Vaishnava is more than that. Vaishnava is more than that. Vaishnava is more than that. It is written, usually I speak, that sun god is very powerful. I know. Fire is powerful. Brahman is powerful. Don't try to fight with them. But Vaishnava is more than that. Vaishnava Tejiyan Sada. Vaishnava Tejiyan Sada. More than Brahman, more than sun god, more than, you know, more than fire. More than Brahman. And in Bhagavatam, 7th canto, you can remember many times I am speaking. Many times I am speaking this argument. Viprat disaraguna yutat arabindanavo. Padarvinda vimukhat sapacham paristam. Sapach, who previously used to cook the flesh of dog, sapach, is more than a Brahman. If he is going to worship Krishna, love Krishna. You know the case of Guhak Chandal? In from Ramayana? Ramchandra going to embrace Guhak Chandal, his Guhak Chandal is from Chandal family. Fallen. But still, Ramchandra give full honor to Guhak Chandal. In Ramayana, you can find. So, Viprab Disaraguna Yutat Aravindanava Padaravinda Vimukhat Sapachambhaisya. Though previously he used to take the flesh of dog, but now he is totally absorbed in Krishna Bhajan, in Bhakti. Now you have no right to speak anything against Jagai Madai. Now you have no right to speak against that Vaishnava. Maybe previously he was there. That was the arrangement. But now he is doing Krishna Bhajan from heart. You have no right to speak. Banni Suryo, Banni Suryo, Brahmanebhyo, Tejyan, Vaishnavo, Sada. Banni, Banni means fire. Banni Suryo, sun god. Banni Suryo, Brahmanebhyo, Tejyan, Vaishnavo, Sada. Be careful, remember. So if you start doing bhajan, then you can grow a glowing feature. Everybody can fear. He's following rules and regulations. So nice. Astuti pronounces, doing bhajan, harinam, firing power. So Vaishnava is more than Brahman. Brahman, 12 qualities, maximum. But Vaishnava, Vaishnava having countless qualities. Krishna bhakte, Krishna gun, sakali sanchari. All the qualities of Krishna can come. All the qualities of Krishna can come inside the heart of a Vaishnava. What to speak more? Even very carefully, if you count, you cannot count. Countless qualities of Vaishnava. Then why you are not going, the society not going to give, hear me. Then again I am speaking same thing. Because the whole society, they are in ignorance. Krishna never wanted to break the system. System should be there for common man, those who are not, you know, elevated. They can follow step by step their rules. That's why Salveg is Musalman. Salveg. He was not allowed to enter the Jagannath temple. He was crying. He bursted into tears. Going to die without the darshan of Jagannath. Jagannath, in front of Jagannath, Salveg speaking. Oh Prabhu, your name is Jagannath. Why you are, your name is Jagannath? I am not out of this Jagat. Jagat means world. You are Jagannath. You are the Nath of this world. And I am not out of this material world. So why I cannot take darshan of you? Why they stop me entering this temple? Please, Prabhu, justify. Then Jagannath was bound to come outside to give darshan in the form of Patit Pavan. So you see, there is no partiality with Jagannath. Don't try to think that way. Jagannath was bound to come and give darshan to Salveg. But for that, we cannot break the system. Ho Salveg, try to bear. Jagannath going to give kipa to you. All Vaishnava love you, respect you. But please, we cannot break this system. In Ramanujaya heredity, you know, there one Acharya's name is Muni Bahan. He wanted to insult a Vaishnava. He don't know his pure Vaishnava. He says, a low caste actually, yeah, useless. He's coming to take water from Godavari. He found that man is lying outside. Hey, go! He thinks, I am Brahman. I am the priest of Pujari Ranganatham. So you are making some contamination. Go! He is not going sleeping. Then he take one stone and throw on him. That is it. Go! The contamination. Then after that, when taking water from Godavari, when reaching the temple, he finds the temple gate is closed by Ranganatham. Not opening. Who closes? Pujaris, they all gone mad. Who closes? Nobody closes. Automatically closed. Then Prabhu speaking, I am not going to take or sip from this Brahman. Provided he is going to beg for pardon from that Vaishnava, my devotee lying outside. He must go and take dust particle from his lotus feet. Not only that, he will have to take on his soldier and do parikrama on my temple 7 or 8 times. After that I can open, otherwise close. From today I am not going to take any seva from you all. You see the quality. You can find the partiality with Bhagavan? No. Supreme Lord love. Bondhu, Bondhu, Mahanto. Bondhu, Mahanto. Was same case. Bondhu, Mahanto. Jagannath. Jagannath himself bring prasadam in golden plate. Inside temple, the king offered this plate. Inside temple, the Spanda, the special offer. Rajbhog. Not that in Bhogamandir, they offered thousands of pot. But that special book, inside temple, golden plate, big golden plate, golden grass and bowls, their special book on behalf of Raja. That book is vanished. Pandas, they search, where gone? Golden plate is in, no, vanished. After that, Jagannath take this plate and go to Bandhu Mahanta and get prasadam, because he is fasting. I bring prasadam, but who are you? Actually, I am staying there. I bring Jagannath prasadam for you. He is staying at the bank of beach, sea beach, taking prasadam, keeping the plate. He don't know it is made of gold. Then all Jagannath, you know, Panda, they are searching. Where gone? Who still? They found it with Bandhu Mahanta, arrest him. No! Thief you are. They put into jail. He said, I am not stealing. Somebody coming this plate to me. I was enjoying prasad. No! You are stealing. Never before this thing happens. We are not going to believe you. Come! They arrest you and go. Follow what I say. After that, night time, Jagannath became very angry and came in dream of Raja, king. Hey, king! Go and set free. He is my devotee, Bandhu Mahanta. Don't! You are going to give punishment? Go! Beg pardon. Then they set free. I took this golden plate and give to him. He is not thief. He is a great devotee. You see, the arrangement of Krishna. So I am bound to speak this way because otherwise you can misunderstand me. Daiva Varanasam you cannot understand. You can misuse to get some advantage, I know. You can fight with me to take some undue advantage. That's why I am bound to give you so much example. You cannot put any allegation against Jagannath. Prabhu Jagannath is always liberal, open heart, want to bless me, want to embrace me. But Jagannath want to keep some balance in this society. If the social system is break, then there in the society, Varna Sankar, all mismanagement can take place. So, you see, Sankaro narakayo ivo kulog nanam kulasacha patanti pitorohi esam putru lupto pindo doka kriyaha. You see, this way, Mahaprabhu, actually, Bhagavan, in front of, you know, Krishna, Arjuna giving this kind of argument, and I can touch this some sloka, and next day I can explain, because time cannot permit. Dosai retoi kulagnanam varna sankara karakai utsad dante yati dharmaha kulu dharmascha sashyata. Same thing I was describing. I can explain it after. Next day. Utsanno kulo dharmanam manusvanam janardano narake niyatam baso bhavati iti anusushramaha. Anusushrama, we are hearing disciplic succession. Heretical, you know, order, we are hearing this thing. Anusushrama. Repeatedly we are hearing. Without any gapping, we are hearing this. Those who are going to break system, you know, then kula dharma ritualistic activities there, you know, applicable in this, you know, current there in their, you know, society, in their race. If they break it, then they are going to break system total. Utsanna kula dharma is special duties, rituality activities there, which is there, and specially. So, all they are going to live in hell. So, aho bato mahat papam kartum bevasita vayam yad rajyo sukha lobhena hantum sajjana muddataha. Yadi mam apratikaram asastram sastrapanayo dhaturashta rane hanyuhus tanme khyamataram bhaved. I am going to explain it next day. What is the gist? Arjuna speaking, if at all they are going to kill me in this battlefield, still I am not going to kill them. Sanjay now giving relay to Andha Dhritarashtra, evam ukta, after speaking this way, evam ukta Arjuna, shankhe rathopasto upavishat. In this rod, in this chariot, Arjuna sit down, collapse. Arjuna sit down, collapse. Follow. Arjuna sit down and collapse. He don't like to fight. Now Sanjay Vacha evam ukta Arjuna sankhe rathopasto upavishat visrijyo sa saram chapam shoko sanvigno manasaha iti Srimad Bhagavate sato sahasrang sanghitayam vayasakyam vismo parvani Srimad Bhagavate gitasu panishatsu brahma vidvayam yoga sastre Sri Krishna Arjuna sangvade sainya darshanam namo prathama adhyaya samaptah. Follow? You see? Now infatuation coming. Soka sanvigna manasaha, Arjun not at all ready to fight and giving this kind of argument. Now next day we can hear what kind of judgment Krishna giving. We can misunderstand that maybe Arjun is very soft, maybe dharma, he is overpowered by dharma, Baba. But Krishna going to speak just opposite. No! What you are doing just opposite? You are a Kshatriya. You have to discharge your duty. You have to do your duty. If you don't do your duty, then it is a big problem. Adharma for you. But anyway, this is Dharma Yuddha. You are not going to fight with them illegally. They are fighting with you illegally. So what's wrong in it? So next day we can hear that one by one argument Krishna giving to Arjuna, we can get the exact clue of Varnasam Dharma, who is going to do what. Very clearly we can get conception. Then we can build up our spiritual life. Without the knowledge of Grita, nobody can build our spiritual life. Be careful about that. Of course, you know, if somehow special keeper you are going to get, like Gaur Kishore Baba not going to read anything, but he is an eternal person. The species case is totally separate. Follow what I say. So, Vancha Kalpaduru Sikhe Pasindhu Bhavichwa Patitanang Pavana Bhavishna Bhyun. So, any kind of question if you have, you can put. No?
One question.
Huh.
Two questions. Huh.
Oh, that's why I am speaking. I already give answer. That is why we are not following the scientific procedure. That's why the whole system background. That I am telling, na? I already told. Same thing I am speaking. Why breakdown? Why people going to marry, say this, that, intercaste? It's big problem. Krishna wanted to make some scientific procedure, but those people become restless. They are going to break the whole system. That's why you are suffering today. That's why you are suffering, na?
Even if they are devotees, you shouldn't still don't mix.
Huh?
Even if they are devotees, you shouldn't mix because it's a different system. Caste system.
Devotee, if they are devotees, so what? No problem. They could marry. There are so many women. So you can marry likely because matching woman, it is written. Mm-hmm. I can show you. You are blind. If you go through Bhagavad Gita, you cannot see. Maharaj, where is there? I can show you. Well, Krishna, Krishna was sent to Gurukul. You can remember. After that, Krishna gone to Mathura again. After that, gone to Dwarka. You can remember, after long period, long gapping. Maybe that time that devotee was old, Sudama Vipra, the friend of Krishna, wanted to take darshan of the lotus feet of Krishna. He went there. That there Krishna speaking and Sudama Vipra speaking. There Krishna speaking one thing. Are you married now? I think you are married. I think you are married by now. I think you are married already. And matching wife you are getting. That matching wife. Sadrishi. It's written Sadrishi. Meaning like husband, like wife. Matching should be there. If not, then you are going to break the whole system. Don't become angry. I can prove scientifically, if you make one society, so long I am living, I can show you. That system, how scientifically applicable. If you don't try to obey it and try to apply this Daivavarna some wrong way and explaining wrong way, then whole system can break down. What to do? I have nothing to do. Follow what I say.